Hello everyone, welcome back. So in this tutorial I am going to tell you DIY hand clutch or purse. This is flox leather purse from Craftingly Connect by Jasmine D. So her name is Jasmine Siddiqui, and this is my clutch. Very spacious, and I love the quality of this clutch. This is hand clutch. You can do decoupage, you can do stenciling. N number of things are there. So this is her visiting card. I will leave her details in description box. Go and check out. I have this napkin. This I will adhere on my clutch itself. So yes, this is my napkin, and this is really beautiful one. I will adhere like this, I think so. Or let's see. So that's how this looks like. I have this brush set also from her, and this is really awesome one as well. I will use iCraft sticky glue for adhering my napkin on my flox leather purse. So you can use any decoupage glue, but I prefer iCraft sticky glue. So yes, that's all about my material. I will use one color also, but will tell you later on. So let's get started. So I'm using 10 number and 1 number brush, 10 for applying glue and 1 number for applying my color. First I'm taking my napkin and will remove 2 layers which usually a napkin have at the back side. Make sure you are removing both the layers, and now my napkin is ready to do the work. So let me just apply glue on my clutch. So I will use the sticky glue from iCraft with 10 number brush. Always use one separate brush for glue or for varnish. Keep that separate itself. Now I will apply my glue horizontally as well as vertically so that I cover each and every area perfectly. Like this. Now I will not glue all over my clutch. I am just taking one side first. One tip for you all. Cover each and every edge really nicely. And what I do, I take one plastic kind of thing and I wear it like a gloves, and then I adhere my napkin so that I didn't tear off my napkin. So likewise I have done this work. Now I will just take my plastic like this to adhere. First, I am taking my napkin without the plastic in my hand. I am not taking plastic. I am just making sure that I make this without wrinkle. Adhere this nicely and then do like this and remove each and every bubbles. Now, this will give you a finished look to your whole clutch. Now my this area is near to be done, and now I will move towards the back side. I will put the glue here also as I have done before, and then I will adhere my napkin. Now one tip for you all is just keep your glue in small container. Use that first and then use next batch. So always use to keep your glue in small container. Transfer that in small container and then use that whole thing. That will be easy for you to store, and that will give life to your glue. So now I think so I'm done with each and every area. I'm just covering the edges. and then I will adhere my napkin. So this is a curvy area here. After the curve, the napkin will give you a little bit of crease. So don't worry about that. Make sure that you adhere napkin well. Try to make it wrinkle free. So I am taking off napkin and then I am putting again. So in this way I am making my whole thing wrinkle free. I will take my plastic on my hand. You can use one plastic gloves as well. And now I will make this wrinkle free. Now once this is done, I will use one brush with water to remove the excess paper or napkin. So this is my bowl of water and this is my one number brush. I will remove the excess napkin. I'm just outlining the edge. Now here comes one more tip. Leave it for half an hour for drying and then go for this step. Once this is done, we have to complete the edge work by giving the same gray color on the edges. So now I am taking very little of water and removing the excess napkin, as I told you before. And in this area, napkin is really little, you know, excess napkin is really less. So I am removing likewise. And only this part is left. And yes, this is done. Now I will just leave this for a couple of minutes and then I will give the edge work. So let's start with the edge thing. On this area I want to give, I'm just putting glue first before doing the edge coloring to adhere my napkin, which are like opened up from the edges. Just giving a stroke of glue. So yes, this is done. Now I am taking iCraft chalk paint dark secret and iCraft chalk paint coconut color, and I will mix them together to make my gray. I am not having the gray, exact gray shade, so I mixed them together to make my gray color. And now I am giving the same color on the edge, also a little bit on inside edge to make one border, and a bit of dry brushing inside to merge the paper with my clutch. So likewise you have to give the edge work, and be sure to give a perfect color to your whole clutch. You can use contrast color, but I don't prefer them. I preferred giving the gray color itself, which matches my napkin. You can add some tassels on zip and it can be more attractive. Now I will complete this area in the same way. One more thing, as I told you before also, do give the dry brushing to merge the napkin with your clutch. Likewise. So I'm done with the edge work, as you can see, and the whole area is done. I have one more pouch. This is makeup pouch from same Jasmine Siddiqui by Craftingly Connect. You can do the same work. You can leave the zip area and you can decoupage this and color the tassel as well and accordingly to your napkin. So now let me show you the final look of this. The camera is not doing justice, so that's why. So that's how this looks like. Hope you like this video. Do like, share and subscribe. We'll be back soon. Till then, bye bye.